Hi, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to edit and add CSS to WordPress. Want to try editing WordPress CSS but have no idea where to start? By editing your WordPress theme and including additional CSS of your own, you'll be able to optimize each and every visual element on your site. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Ready to start? Let's do it. CSS stands for Cascading Style Sheets, and it's the most popular web language besides HTML. The two of them go hand in hand as CSS is used to style HTML elements. HTML lays the groundwork of a website's appearance, and CSS is used to further style it. CSS gives you the ability to make a website responsive, add colors, change fonts, modify the layout, and in general, fine-tune a website's visual presentation. Like HTML and JavaScript, CSS is a front-end client-side language, which means it executes on the user's end rather than on the backside of the server. If you want to customize your theme and change how your site looks with CSS, you'll need to either add your own code or edit what's already there. To change existing theme code, you'll have to access your site's style sheet. As you make these changes, there's one thing you should know. When your theme updates, any edits you've made to style.css, functions.php, or other theme template files will be erased. In general, you shouldn't be making direct changes to your website in the editor without using a child theme. There are two ways to access your WordPress website style sheet, through the WordPress dashboard or via an FTP client. We'll cover both of these options. Not comfortable doing this yourself? Consider hiring a WordPress developer to handle this step for you. The easiest and most convenient way to access your CSS style sheet is right in the WordPress dashboard. There's no need to install FTP programs or code editors. You can directly edit any file with syntax highlighting and function documentation built in. Remember, before you do any major edits to core files, you should always back up your WordPress site. Once you've made a backup and a child theme, log into your backend. You can find the editor by going to the menu and clicking Appearance, then Theme Editor. You should see a pop-up warning you against making direct edits to these files. Don't worry, just click I understand. It's only a warning to use a child theme and back up your website before you make any major changes. Follow these steps and it'll be safe to edit. And so now you're in. You should be on the style sheet by default, but look to the menu on the right to view your theme files if not. And just remember, most CSS changes you make here will be global. For instance, if you change your H1 headers to a certain font, it will take effect for every single page on your site. You'll need to use a special syntax to customize specific pages' styling. So, what if you can't access the theme editor or prefer to do your work over FTP? It's easier to use the backend editor, but some themes or plugins may disable it. If that's the case, you'll need to connect your WordPress through FTP like FileZilla or another FTP client. Next, you should contact your host and ask for your FTP credentials. You'll need your host, port, and username and password if applicable. If your host has a dashboard, you might be able to find them by logging in. Kinsta users' credentials are located in the My Kinsta dashboard under Sites, then SFTP SSH. Once you have them, launch your FTP client and enter that information. If it doesn't work, try putting SFTP:// before the URL in the host section. Once you're in, you can find your style.css file by clicking the WP content folder to open it, then your themes folder, then scrolling until you see style.css. Double-click to open it or right-click and select View Edit and make your modifications. Remember to save and upload back to the server. If you're not looking to edit the existing CSS code and just want to add your own styling instead, it's strongly suggested to use one of the following methods: WordPress Customizer or use a dedicated plugin. For one, the CSS code added through one of these methods is a lot easier to access and use. You don't need to worry about putting your new CSS in the wrong place or forgetting where you added it if you want to make modifications later. Also, CSS added through one of these methods won't be lost when your theme updates. This means you don't need to use a child theme, and if something breaks, all you have to do is remove the CSS you just added. While you can just add code to style.css and call it a day, if you don't want to create a child theme, make major edits to existing CSS in your theme and potentially end up with all your work erased. it's best to either use the additional CSS option in the WordPress customizer or install a plugin. Instead of using the theme editor, try the WordPress customizer. Log into your WordPress backend and click Appearance and then Customize to open the theme customization screen. You'll see a live preview of your website with options on the left to customize elements like the colors, menus, or other widgets. At the very bottom of this menu, you should find the additional CSS box. Click to open it. You'll be taken to a new screen with a code input box and a few instructions. The additional CSS screen includes syntax highlighting, just like the theme editor, along with validation that lets you know if your code is wrong. Any code you write automatically appears in the preview area on the right, unless it has an error, though you can choose to publish it anyways. When you're done working, you can publish your code, schedule when it'll take effect, or save it as a draft to work on later. You can even get a preview link to share with others. As you can see, the additional CSS page is in many ways more powerful than the theme editor, and much more suited to adding code than messing with core files. The CSS code you write here overwrites the default styling of your theme, and it doesn't disappear when your theme updates. If you can't see it live on your preview, double-check you're using the correct selectors in your CSS code. Just like with the theme editor, CSS is global by default, but you can write code that targets specific pages. The one downside is that, should you switch themes, anything you've written will be erased. Make sure to back up your CSS before moving to a new theme, or you might end up losing a lot of work. If you're struggling to use this option or want a solution that works across themes and can more easily target certain pages, you should try a plugin instead. Which brings me to number two. While the function of CSS plugins are similar to the additional CSS menu, styles will usually stick even if you switch or update themes. Simple Custom CSS is the most popular CSS editor plugin due to its ease of use, minimal interface, and lightweight backend. In short, it's a very small WordPress plugin that packs a big punch. Setting it up is a breeze, and you'll see no negative impact on performance. It works on any theme and includes syntax highlighting and error checking. Simple Custom CSS in JS is a good alternative. It also lets you target the header, footer, front end, and even the admin backend. Site Origin CSS is another option that also includes a traditional CSS editor. You'll be able to switch between it and the visual editor at any time. If you're struggling to add CSS to specific pages, WP Add Custom CSS adds a custom CSS box to the editing screen and also comes with global styling. You may also want to consider trying a visual CSS editor. These take all the complicated coding and turn it into a series of easy-to-do input fields and drop-down menus, which handle all the programming for you. CSS Hero is a premium visual editing plugin with some seriously powerful features, like animation, device-specific edits, and non-destructive editing, to name a few. As a WordPress user, jumping into CSS might be confusing at first, but once you know how to edit your theme files and where to add styling, you should have no more trouble. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.